Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you some of the new additions to my wardrobe. These are things that I've added in anticipation of spring. I am of course going to be shopping my wardrobe from last year, but I just wanted to give things a little bit of a refresh. This video is also in collaboration with ShopTagger. You guys know I've partnered up with them a couple of times previously and I absolutely love their service. I actually used it last night to nab a dress that I was really wanting to buy but had been sold out in my size for a while. So if you haven't heard of ShopTagger, it's kind of like, I would describe it as your personal shopping assistant. So you go onto a website and just say you want to buy something but it's maybe a little bit out of your price range or your size is not in stock. ShopTagger will alert you when the item comes back in stock or if it goes on sale, which I think is really amazing, and it's a great way for you to be able to add those core items to your wardrobe without necessarily having to break the bank. Now, in order to use ShopTagger, you just need to add the button to your browser. Personally, I think that Chrome is the best way to go in terms of using ShopTagger, and you can download that little button from their website. Then when you're browsing your favorite stores and you see something that you really want to buy but maybe you want to sit on it for a little while, which is definitely one of my favorite tips in terms of making sure that you add things to your wardrobe that are going to last the distance and be in there for years, is you can add it to one of your lists. So I've got a few different ones set up and I sort of split them across clothing, shoes, bags, and also kind of really core wardrobe staples. And then you can decide whether you want to be alerted if the item gets discounted a certain rate or just if it has any price change. I do find that ShopTagger also alerts you if there is a discount code, which I think is really awesome because I know I definitely take advantage of those a lot. And then the other thing that you can do is you can share your list with your loved ones. So just say you've got a birthday coming up or with Christmas on its way, it's really not that far away now. You can always share your Christmas list maybe with your family or with your partner if you want to give them a hint as to what to buy you. I have dropped a link for ShopTagger in the description box below, so please be sure to go and check that out. With that all being said, I want to dive right into it and start with one of my favorite brands, which you guys probably know what it is. It's Emmeline. I bought a few things from there recently, which was really just inspired by trying to fulfill a couple of items I had on my spring wardrobe wishlist, which if you haven't read that blog post, I'll also drop that in the description as well. So the first thing that I snapped up was this terry crew neck sweater, and this is in a bone color, and what I really wanted to find was a nice white sweatshirt to wear with a lot of my denim skirts or even something a little bit fancier to make it seem a little bit more relaxed. I thought this would work really well with some trousers, but I sort of foresee me wearing this a lot with my skinny jeans or with my denim skirts. I think you guys know by now denim is sort of a really big staple in my closet, and I'm lucky enough to be able to wear much more relaxed outfits every single day. So I got this in a extra small and it is a loose fit on me. I do find that it's a little bit shrunken, which I like. It's got a cropped length and the sleeves do have a little bit of volume to them compared to other sweatshirts that I've owned. So I personally prefer to wear this scrunched up the arms. I think that's sort of the best way to style it, and I will insert some clips, but it's just really comfortable, really nice and snuggly, and I always find that the rule of thumb for most things from Emmeline is to size down, and I have done a few reviews, so if you want to see my most recent video review, I will drop that in the cards up here. Moving on to my second piece that I bought from Emmeline in that order, and you guys will have seen this in my spring wardrobe lookbook. If you haven't watched that already, I'm gonna put it up here. There's going to be a few different videos and things for you guys to check out, but I was gifted this sweater in the ochre color and I loved it so much that I decided to buy it in black, and it's the cotton turtleneck. So you're probably not going to be able to see this too well on camera, but it's just a sort of slightly faded black turtleneck. It's got this rib detail around the collar and also around the edges of the sleeves and the hem. It's a really nice oversized boxy fit. I like the fact that it's got the split hem detail on the side. I went for a size small just because I wanted it to fit me really nice and loose, and I think this looks really great just half tucked into things or worn loose. I personally really like how it looks with a black skirt. You could even wear this with something a little bit more kind of formal for the office. I think it will look really great paired with a pattern as well, like maybe some houndstooth or a check. but it's just a really great sort of transitional weather piece, and I sort of foresee me wearing this a lot in the next, you know, few years to come, because it really is a classic staple, and the cotton just feels really, really nice. So I'm very, very pleased with this one. It's actually probably one of my favorite items from this haul. Then the final item I have from Evelyn was actually gifted to me. Now, I had someone ask me a few videos back if I could do a video sharing some styling ideas for a white denim jacket, and they were kind enough to send me one so that I could show you some different styling options. So this is their denim jacket in the bone. You can kind of see I've still got the label in there. I haven't had a chance to wear it yet, but I got this in a small, and I will say it is very, very oversized on me, so do size down. If you're thinking about buying this jacket in any of the colors, I really like the washed black denim. I actually think that is very, very chic. And it's quite boxy in terms of the fit throughout the body as well. So if that's not something that works for your body shape, then this is definitely not going to be for you. Even though it is a little bit too big for me, I do sort of feel like it's something I can make work. And I actually really like how it pairs with the outfit that I'm wearing today. So I've got the striped top on and a denim skirt and just some black pumps. And I think it looks really chic with the sleeves rolled up. I also think that this looks really great with just washed black denim in general, so a nice skinny jean. And the other way that I would probably wear this is over the top of a little sundress. So that's kind of how I would wear a white denim jacket, and I'm kind of looking forward to styling this up a lot more. So yeah, that is item number 3. Next, I want to talk about a couple of items from Redone. So on that same spring wardrobe wishlist, you will have seen that I had one of Redone's white, just classic tees on there, because I really want something that's got a slightly more shrunken fit, something that is really classic and timeless, because all of the t-shirts that I have some sort of detail on it, whether it's embroidery or a pocket or rolled up sleeves. There's just a little detail that makes it a little bit more special, but I really wanted something that was very simple and that I could just pair with absolutely everything. Now, the team at Redone were actually kind enough to send me a couple of things, and they sent me the classic tee. It's in black, but I think I'm going to be getting just as much wear out of this, because I lost my Everlane Air tee. I've got no idea where it went, and I've been looking for it for months. So this is going to be taking the spot of that for sure. So this is just the black classic t-shirt. So I really like the fabric of it. It's got a lot of stretch to it, and it is very, very ever so slightly sheer. It's quite subtle, so you wouldn't even notice. I definitely wear a black bra underneath this, but I love the way that this fits, and it is slightly cropped, so it's really great if you wear a lot of high-waisted things like I do. Then the second thing that they sent me is a pair of their jeans, and I actually have this pair of jeans in another color, and they're one of my favorite pairs of jeans, so I was really excited to add another color to my wardrobe. And you guys are gonna laugh, because I feel like I've gotten so many black jeans recently, but they're a washed black, but they've got a slight petrol hue to them, so almost a bit of a dark blue undertone. I'm not quite sure how best to describe it, but it's got the butterfly. My usual size again, a 25. I do find that with Redone jeans, they might fit really snug at first, but they relax over time. So I am so chuffed with these, and I'm really looking forward to wearing them a lot more just during this transitional period. They do have the raw edge hems as well. They look a lot neater than the ones on my other pair, which maybe I can show a photo or something of them so you can see. I've got the other ones in blue. But yeah, just another great little staple piece for my wardrobe. Then maybe let's talk about some more denim. So I have been wanting these jeans from Topshop for a really long time. I've never really seen them in store, so I decided to just go for it on the website instead. And they were constantly out of stock in my size. So I used Shop Tagger to actually get notified as to when my size came back in stock. So these are the Topshop Moto straight leg jeans, and I've got them in the waist 25, leg 30. So I carry a lot of my height and my body. I talk about this all the time, but I find that a 32 leg is sometimes a little bit too long for me, just because I liked my jeans to be slightly cropped. It's personally what I think is the most flattering on everybody, but particularly on my silhouette. So these are just a really nice vintage blue wash. I really, really love the color of them. They're very kind of straight through the leg. I don't think Luke particularly loved these, but I think that they're really cool, and I think they look really flattering over the bums. As you guys know, I've been sort of gravitating a lot more towards straight leg jeans as of late, and these are definitely kind of another one to add to my little growing collection of jeans. I probably do not need any more for a while now. The other thing that I picked up in the same order is a little bit of a wild card piece for me, because this is so different to anything that I've worn, but I've kind of been, I guess, shifting towards wearing some more fitted tops. And I saw this little wrap crop top, I guess, which has the ribbed detail and it's really stretchy with long sleeves. So I figured this would be a really great option to wear with so many of my high-waisted items, because you have the crisscross along the front and then there's a little bit of skin that peeks out from the bottom. So nice pair with something high-waisted, which would just show a little glimpse of skin, and really good just while we transition towards the warmer months. I know I'm not going to have too much opportunity to wear this because Sydney spring is sort of like 4 weeks long before we dive deep into summer, but I think that that's a really cute one, and I went for a size 8 in this one. I think it's a really good fit. Then I bought two pairs of trousers just because I wanted something that looked really smart. And you guys know I've got the Uniqlo Smart Ankle, I think they're called the Smart Ankle Trouser, which I wear a lot, but I want something a little bit different and that had a bit more structure to it. So when I saw these ones from Zara and they've got a bit of a pleated detail at the front, I thought, or pin tuck pleat detail, I thought that they would fill that gap really nicely. So it's really dark. I will show you on the cutaway. Essentially, they're a high-waisted slim fit trouser that have got a pleat detail down the center, which I think is really nice. I think it just elevates the trouser look really nicely. The pin tuck pleating along the front looks really, really chic. I just think it's very different to anything else that I have. And there are pockets as well, which is always a bonus. And they're a slightly cropped style on me, which personally is my preference. So I'm really, really pleased with these, and I can definitely see myself wearing them a lot. I'll probably be alternating between the Uniqlo ones and these ones here. And then the other trousers that I got are from Grano. I'm going to have to press these before I do the try on, but these are their silk ankle pants. Now, I've owned a few pairs of these, but I've never really gotten the wear out of them, and I think it's because I always went for a colour or something that wasn't overly classic. So I was inspired to buy these after chatting with my best friend Emily, which, if you're watching, hey, because both of us have really, really been keen on buying the Juliet Hogan silk trousers, and I can't remember the style name, but I will link them down below in case you want to check them out. But they're just a really classic, tailored ankle length silk trouser, which are perfect for the office but really great for the weekend as well. And she said to me that she recently bought these and they were one of the best things that she had bought, and she said you should buy them because they'll be a great alternative and they're not quite as expensive. I think they're called the Lennox. Actually, they're around the $500 mark, so they're a big splurge, and clearly with our renovations and things, it's not really my top priority to be spending that much money on a pair of trousers. So I picked them up in the black and I'm really happy with them, and I actually can see how these are going to get a lot more wear than the pink and the white ones that I had. So looking forward to wearing these. I've got them in the small with the regular length, and I find they come just above the ankle, which is perfect. The one thing I will say about these trousers is that the pockets are basically non-existent. I don't know if you can see that, but that's basically as much as my hand as I can get in there, so not ideal. I do wish that they were a bit bigger, but I mean, that's really the only major design flaw with these trousers, but otherwise they're really nice. They are double lined. She was telling me that the flat front trousers are not double lined, so if you really want that nice sort of very luxurious silky feel, then go for just the classic ankle length silk trousers that they do. They're really, really lovely, and I know that you can hand wash these as well. Then the final thing that I want to share in this video is a coat, and I know what you're thinking, that's absolutely crazy because you're going into summer. However, I am planning on doing a new sort of autumn themed workwear lookbook, and that's going to be coming really soon, so do keep an eye out, particularly if you're in the Northern Hemisphere. And I reached out to Bodum because I thought one of their coats would be really perfect, and they very, very kindly sent it to me. I honestly am beyond lucky, and I think it's such a beautiful coat, and I wish I had it for the Australian winter because I think I would have been wearing this every single day. So it's this really beautiful houndstooth robe style coat. So it's got these huge oversized lapels, it's got a wrap detail at the waist, and then it's kind of a midi length, and it's fully lined with a beautiful navy lining, and the fabric is actually kind of a I would call it a creamy grey with navy. So it's really gorgeous, and I think that this is the kind of coat that would just go with every single outfit. So that is everything that I have added to my wardrobe recently. I hope that you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you're new and you want to watch more videos like this from me. I will see you guys next time with a brand new video. See you soon. Bye.